I'm so sorry, sweetheart. Please forgive me. This is all my fault. I'll do whatever it takes to save you, I swear. My name's Derek Pierce. I'm grateful to everyone here for giving me the chance to share my problems. Thanks to all of you, I don't feel so alone. My wife's in a coma. We got into a car accident, and I have only myself to blame. I lost control when... A few months ago, we were the happiest couple on earth. Christina's the light of my life. I'll never forget the day it happened. I should have kept a closer eye on the road. Christina's in a coma because of me, and I'll never forgive myself for it.
Hello, Derek. Don't ask how I know your name. That isn't important. What matters is that I know what you wish for more than anything in the world. Doctors are powerless against what's happened to your wife. You know that as well as I do. However, I can help you. I can heal her. The price is a mere trifle. A year of your life in exchange for Christina's recovery. To seal our deal, you give me the most treasured thing you have, your wedding ring. A year of your life and a small piece of metal for the life of your beloved. Go home, my friend. It's already done.
It all seems like some kind of cruel joke. I need to get home to Christina.
Derek, darling. What happened? I don't know how I got here. The last thing I remember is bright headlights and a crash. We've had an accident, haven't we? It's strange that I feel so rested, but it wasn't a dream. Please, call the doctor so we can make sure I'm all right. His phone number must be written somewhere around here. I'm going to take a shower in the meantime. Thank you.
Doctor, could you please come to our house? My wife, Christina Pierce, came out of her coma.
It can't be. I'll be right over. I need to examine her. I can't believe it, Christina. You look completely fine. However, it's best if we double check. I need to examine you. Mr. Pierce, you don't have to be here for this.
It's all right, Derek. It won't take long. Don't worry.
Days of freedom left. Then I'll take complete control of your body for a year. Meanwhile, you'll just be a helpless observer.
You tricked me! Get out!
You don't look like him. There's not a stranger spirit in you, is there? If not, do me a favor and find my pills. Then we'll talk. Several years ago, I visited the support group. Then the creature from the lamp offered to cure my father. I paid with a year of my life. When the creature left my body, it negatively affected everything. The incident exhausted me and left me traumatized. I closed myself off from everyone, including my family and friends. I tried to find information about the lamp and found some in a book, but I had to stop searching when the creature appeared in a new body and threatened me. When I saw you come in, I thought that the creature was in your body and had come for me. I'm tired of living in fear. This book contains all the information I collected. Hopefully it will help you more than it did me. Take it and never come back.
Don't you dare stand in my way!
Has it gone? Are you yourself again?
Don't worry, everything's all right. You don't have to be scared of me.
I thought I was done for. It hasn't completely taken over your body yet, has it? So we still have time. Take this book. I didn't manage to decipher it, but hopefully you can. Then you can free us both from the creature. There's a fortune teller who has a store down the street. She used to help me a lot using her gift. You should visit her. Maybe she can help you.
good evening. Would you like to take a peek at what your future holds? Oh, no. It's you again. Stay away from me!
I dreamed of treating people all my life, but that horrible plague hit the town like a hurricane. It killed half the residents, including my wife and son. I dove into research, trying to invent a cure for all diseases, but I wasn't successful. Then I prayed to the forgotten gods, and they answered me. ...100 years of life seemed a small price for saving people from disease and grief. But no one told me I wouldn't be the one to pay. By the time I realized what was happening, it was too late.
Certainly scared me. When I was young, the creature appeared to me and promised to return if I interfered. I've watched it destroy human lives for far too long. It's time I finally do something. So, you managed to decipher the book and found a drawing? I haven't seen this house before, but my tarot cards might show us the way. Darn, I don't remember where I put the deck. Will you try finding it? My locket might help. In the meantime, I need to relax and focus. The hourglass card symbolizes the time allotted to you, and it's getting short. Collect 3 hourglass cards faster than me, and the tarot cards will show you the way. Thank you. I knew the cards might give a hint, but not so literally. Take this map. It shows the way to that house. It looks like you can find all the answers there to get rid of the creature. Now hurry. I see you're running out of time. It's close.
Is it my study?
That was so long ago. I used to have a family, a wife, and a son. But I was obsessed with the idea of creating a remedy for all diseases. They couldn't bear that kind of life, so they left me. My research came to a dead end. So I turned my back on science and I offered up a prayer to an ancient god. I asked for a remedy for all illnesses. At first, I didn't want to take a year of life in exchange for healing, but then I started to believe it was a small price to pay. And after many years, I even started liking it. That's when I truly lost myself.
Thank you. My old locket has awoken me. My name is Peter Gordon, and I'm the creature that healed your wife. Well, part of it, to be precise. I wasn't always like this. I was once driven by the desire to create a remedy for all diseases. Instead, I became a monster. At the very beginning, I studied the lamp and discovered a way to set myself free, but I never managed to get it done. If you want to save yourself, this burden now falls on you. Take this key. It will open my research.
Thank you.
Thank you, Derek. You have no idea how nice it is to feel alive after so many years. My dream blinded me, but if we destroy the lamp, I'll have a second chance. Healing your wife weakened the creature, but it's gaining strength every minute. Take a look at the addition to the house. I managed to make something there before I lost myself. I didn't have time to find out how to destroy the lamp, but I'm sure it's worth looking where all of this began. I received the lamp in an old abandoned chapel. This car's pretty old, but I'm sure you can fix it. Then you'll get behind the wheel and I'll show you the way to the chapel. Thank you. here we are. This is where it all started, so this is where it should end. I performed a ritual here many years ago. Now it's your turn, Derek. I don't have enough strength to touch the lamp. You were recently under its influence, so you can do it. I used to have a key to this chapel, but now it's broken. Here, this might help. Thank you.
Since the time of the ancients, people have prayed to the gods and asked them to make their lives easier. They prayed for a good harvest. For power and wealth. And in answer to their prayers, it fulfilled the wish of any person, but it took the time allotted to them by the gods in return. The ancient gods entered into a battle with the creature, but even they couldn't manage to destroy it. So they cast a spell to trap it in a magic lamp, tying them together forever. By touching the lamp, one could awaken the creature and make their wish. And so the centuries, like arrows, flew by. The gods left this world long ago, but the creature remains and accumulates its strength by taking away the will of those who dare to ask. Only someone with a pure heart can pick up the artifacts of the old gods, and with their help, defeat the creature.
Where have you been? I was so worried.
Don't worry, sweetheart. Everything will be all right now.
I want to start with a clean slate, but I can't do it alone. So I want to attend the group meetings again.
My pride blinded me, and I let you down. But thanks to Derek Pierce, I got a second chance. I'll use it to bring good to the world and make amends. And then we'll finally be reunited.